Hello and welcome to Beaver's Hobby Channel. In this video, I am going to talk about gear mesh and gear ratio. I will also show you how to modify the mortar case of WLtoys 120F, the K989 and K969, to be able to use almost any pinion gear size. And at the end, I will run some tests to see how different gear ratios affect the speed of the car. I have the links to skip to different parts in the description below, so feel free to use it if you don't want to wait or watch the whole video for the thing you want to see. First, let's talk about gear mesh, and I am going to use Lego to give you some visual aid of what I am talking about. To put it simply, gear mesh refers to the gap of the cogs or teeth between two gears, and when the gears spin, they mesh together. If the gear mesh is too tight, it will stress the mortar and could lead to overheating problem, either from the mortar because it has to work harder, or from the ESC because it has to pump more amps to the mortar. If the gear mesh is too loose, it will slip and it will strip the gear teeth, so it is crucial to set the gear mesh properly. In many RC cars, you can manually set up the gear mesh, so you can have variety of pinion and spur to set up the gear ratio. Now I will show you how to set up the gear mesh properly using my WLtoys to demonstrate. First, loosen the screws that hold the mortar in place. So you can move it around like this. Then put the pinion gear on the mortar. The next thing you need is a strip of paper. Any paper would do, but not too thick. Now put the paper between two gears. Press them together and then tighten the screws. Once the mortar is secure, you can pull the paper out. A good gear mesh should stamp the gear on the paper without tearing through it. If the gears tear through the paper, this means the mesh is too tight. And if there is no stamper on the paper, the mesh is too loose. What you want is just enough amount of slop, so the gear can spin freely, just like this. Next, let's talk about gear ratio. Gear ratio basically means how many rotations of one gear equals to one rotation of the other. We can calculate it easily by dividing the teeth number of the spur gear, the big one, by the teeth number of the pinion gear, the small one from the mortar. Lower ratio means that the motor will spin less round for the center shaft to spin one round. This results in higher top speed, but less torque and less acceleration. Higher ratio means the opposite. The motor has to spin more round for the center shaft to spin one round. This results in lower top speed, but more torque and better acceleration. It boils down to this. Lower ratio is for speed. Higher ratio is for acceleration. Now, let's take a look at how to modify the mortar case of WLtoys to accommodate bigger or smaller pinion. Normally, there is not much wiggle room for the mortar to put an extra large pinion or extra small pinion on the mortar. But this can be modified very easily with just two files. Use the big curved file to widen the hole in the middle for the mortar shaft. And small round file to widen the holes for the screws. And that's it. Now I have a motor case that I can use from 12 teeth to 20 teeth pinion with 29 teeth spur gears. Let me show you the speed of the different gear ratios. I am going to use the speed checker that I built from Arduino and replace one wheel with this encoder disc. The result will be the wheel speed in revolution per second and the calculated speed from 25 diameter tires. Remember, this is only the rotational speed without load. So, in reality, when the car is on the ground, it will not go as fast as this measured speed. But this should give you some idea of how the gear ratio works. In all the tests, the spur gear is stock 29 teeth. First up, let's start with the smallest pinion I have, 12 teeth, with the gear ratio of 2.42. Next, 15 teeth, the weapon of choice for drifting at 1.39 ratio. You can see the speed starting to go up. The next one is the stock pinion of this car, 17 teeth, at 1.7 ratio. This is the speed of a standard WLtoys. Let's kick it up a notch to 18 teeth. Now I have 1.6 gear ratio. And finally, the biggest pinion I have, 20 teeth, at 1.45 ratio. As you can see, the bigger the pinion is, there is less gear ratio and more top speed. And that's it for this video. I hope you enjoy it. Please subscribe if you haven't done it yet to stay tuned. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.